Howie Roseman has changed the game. We saw it again today. Buffalo Bills send away their left tackle, Cordy Glenn, to the Cincinnati Bengals so they could swap first-round picks. So the Bills, who originally had two firsts, they still have two firsts, but instead of picking 20 and 21, they sent the 21st pick to Cincinnati, and they got the Bengals 12th. So you see what's going on here? You can kind of connect the dots. Remember when the Eagles traded up from number 13 to number 8, packaging Byron Maxwell, Kiko Alonso in a deal to Miami, and they go from 8 to 2. Well, I already see it. It's going to happen. Buffalo is going to move up to number 3. Maybe. Depends what Denver and New York do, because the Broncos have the 5th pick, Jets have the 6th pick. And, well, if they want to trade up to number 3, it might be more enticing for those two teams because they're still picking in the top 10. If you're Buffalo at number 12, you know, not as enticing for Indianapolis. But as you can see right now, the Bills are desperately trying to trade up for a quarterback. They want one of those four. They want a Baker Mayfield. They want Josh Rosen, Sam Darnold, or Josh Allen. They want one of those four guys, one of those in the quartet. And they're going to try their damn hardest to get up into the top 5. And unfortunately for the Eagles, this takes a suitor away for Nick Foles. And I don't know if Nick Foles is going to get traded. This move hurts Nick Foles' value because I was hoping that a bidding war would occur for Nick between the Bills and the Cardinals. Now, the Cardinals still have the 15th pick, but would they really be willing to trade the first rounder to the Eagles for Nick? I don't know. They might rather have somebody they can sign on the free agent market instead of having to give up draft compensation. Or we could see something where, you know, you swap first round picks. Because moving up from 32 to 15, it's like 500 points on the draft chart, which is like the value of a second-round pick. So you'd see like a swap, and then maybe you'd get like a second and another pick in return. But as of right now, this trade hurts Nick Foles' trade value. And I don't think Nick Foles is going anywhere. I think Nick Foles is going to be on the Eagles roster. Because the Eagles aren't going to get what they want for Nick. And at the end of the day, you know, it's fine. If you can't get anything great for Nick, I don't want to just give him away. So while I've been in favor of trading Nick Foles, I also don't want to just give him away and just trade him just to trade him. That's stupid. So because of this swap, Buffalo has the intentions of trading into the top 5, top 10 to land one of those four quarterbacks. That's where they're going. You know, they should have just tanked last season so they didn't have to give up anything. But obviously they wound up making the postseason as probably the worst 6th seed in the history of the playoffs. Minus 52, I believe, point differential they had last year. So there's that. And as for the Bengals, they get much-needed help at left tackle. I mean, they struggled mightily along the offensive line last year. They had no idea how much Andrew Whitworth's departure would hurt them. And, you know, they tried to draft guys, Cedric Oboye and, what's the other guy's name? The kid from Oregon. Those two haven't amounted much of anything. So they get a left tackle, and the Bills, they're trying to be like Howie Roseman and the Eagles. They're trying to trade up again to go get their quarterback. So with that being said, I'm Adrian Fedkiw. I'm out. Peace.